All right, so first thing you want to do if you're working along with me is select the circle with the black arrow tool and notice that it has a yellow stroke and no fill. Next, you want to go up to the effect menu, choose 3D, and then choose Revolve in order to bring up the 3D Revolve dialog box. At which point, I'll go ahead and turn on the preview checkbox so we can see what's happening. All right, so I'm going to drag the edge of this box downward. Notice that it's a red edge, just so that we can see this circle revolving around its left side. So notice that we've got this offset option. We'll check that out in just a moment. And then it says from left edge. If I were to switch it to right edge, notice in the document window that we're now revolving the circle around its right edge instead. All right, I'm going to switch it back to left edge so that you can see what happens if I increase the offset value. Instead of there being no room around the circle as it gets rotated, the offset value gives us a hole in the middle of the ring. And just for the sake of demonstration, I'm going to set this offset value to 200 points, at which point you can drag the box around in order to rotate that ring in space. Now, you also have the option of determining how much revolution is going to occur. By default, the angle value is set to 360 degrees, which is its maximum. But notice if you set it to 0 degrees and then press the tab key, that we lose the shape entirely, and that's because we're doing no revolving whatsoever. But if I were to press shift up arrow in order to increase this angle value, then you can see that we're getting more and more revolution, and ultimately I'm turning that circle into a kind of noodle. And if I want to see into the noodle, I just have to drag this red edge upward. We also have a cap option, which is going to control whether or not we're seeing the stroke in this case. So if I turn it off, then we're seeing into the edges of the noodle. That's not what I'm looking for, so I'll just go ahead and turn the cap option back on. And I'm going to increase that angle value as well. So I just want you to see that we're essentially turning this thing into a kind of inner tube at this point. And now, by the way, I'm once again dragging the cube, this time by one of its green edges. All right, so let's say we want to make this thing look a little more golden. In that case, I'd go ahead and drag this circle up here, down in the lighting options. Of course, we want surface to be set to plastic shading. I do want the light intensity for this particular light to be 100%. I'm going to take the ambient light value down to 0. I'll set the highlight intensity to 100. I'm looking for a highlight size of 50%. And just so that we get the smoothest results possible, I'm going to crank this blend steps value up to its maximum, which is 256. Now, I don't really want the shading color to be black, so I'll go ahead and click on it and choose custom. And then I'll click on that color swatch in order to bring up the color picker dialog box. And I'll set the hue value to 270 degrees, which, by the way, is violet, in order to more or less match the background. I'll set the saturation to 50%, and I'll take the brightness down to 10%. Now, something I want you to notice here is that Illustrator is not previewing the color until I click OK, at which point I will see that color applied. All right, now I'm going to add another light source by clicking on a little page icon, and I'll drag it up to the top of the sphere, and I'll click on a little page icon again in order to create a third light source. I'll drag it down to about here, and then I'll click on this icon in order to move the light to the back of the shape. All right, now let's adjust the angle of the item here. By changing this first value, the pitch, to negative 40 degrees, and then I'll change the yaw to 20 degrees, and finally I'll set the roll value, the z-axis, to negative 60 degrees to produce this effect here. Now, obviously, if we want a ring, we want to revolve the thing all the way around. So I'm going to set this angle value to 360 degrees, and we'll end up with this effect here. And then finally, I'm going to increase the perspective value. Notice if I crank it up here, the ring appears to bend toward us. Now, once again, we end up getting that wireframe effect. So I'm just going to set this value to, let's say, 70 degrees. It's going to work out nicely. And then just to get rid of the wireframe, I'll take the angle value, let's say, down to 350 degrees for a moment, at which point I get a little bit of a break. Notice that. And then I'll set it back up to 360 degrees in order to complete the effect. And then if I press the tab key, presumably Illustrator will go ahead and preview the effect. Not really happening, it doesn't look like. So you know what? I'm just going to click OK and see if things right themselves. And it looks like we still have that break. I'm not sure why. So I'll press Shift up arrow and then Shift down arrow to try to inspire the application to get with the program. But given that that's not working, I'll just go ahead and switch to the Appearance panel, and I will click on 3D Revolve in order to modify my settings. Problem is, the angle value didn't take, so I'll just go ahead and take that guy back up to 360 degrees, and then I'll turn on the Preview checkbox, and sure enough, we have an entirely complete ring. All right, now I'll click OK. Now notice, if you will, that we're ending up with some kind of crackly edges down here. And those are actual real edges. That's the effect that we're going to get. And so if you're interested in covering up those effects, I have a solution for you, although depending on the power of your machine, it may end up being a little painful. But here's what you do. Go up to the Effect menu, choose Stylize, and then choose Inner Glow. Do not turn on the preview checkbox at this point. Instead, just go ahead and click on the color swatch and dial in these values. I'm looking for a hue of 48 degrees, a saturation of 49%, and a brightness value of 100%, at which point I'll click OK. And then I'm looking for a blend mode of color dodge. I've set the opacity to 50%, and the blur is set to 8 points. You want to select the edge option right here. And then, if you like, go ahead and turn on the preview checkbox. Now, this happens to be an extraordinarily powerful machine at this point in time, so the preview occurs pretty darn quickly. In your case, it may go a little bit more slowly. All right, but in the end, I'll click OK in order to accept that change. And then I'll just go ahead and zoom out so I can take in the entire ring.